have breaking news out of Georgia this morning. Overnight information on a projected winner in one of the runoff elections. Mercy Health Lourdes is adding a new program to give their cancer patients hope through a Kentucky nonprofit called Gilda's Club. It supports all cancer patients, giving them access to resources and all different kinds of programs. The United States of America has faced its trials of tragedies and turmoil, from the civil rights movement when millions fought for equality to world wars where millions lost their lives. All right, raise your hand if you're guilty of taking a ridiculous number of pictures of your pet.
There's Pauline raising her hand.
Look at Bunny.
Look at Bunny.
Every child and teen in foster care deserves that love. And we wanted to share Sarah's inspiring story because you can make a difference in a foster care child's life as well. Tomorrow is the day Congress will meet in a joint session for the final step to confirm President-elect Joe Biden's win after the results of November's election were certified by the Electoral College last month. The National Guard has been activated ahead of planned protests in Washington, D.C. for tomorrow. May not have been the giant crowds that usually pack New York City's Times Square, but hundreds of people did get to welcome the new year together overnight. But once all the celebrations wrapped up, it was time for the real work to begin. Out of isolation, you're able to get your second dose of the vaccine. It doesn't disqualify you. Hausman says some people may not trust the vaccine, but scientists have been working for years behind the scenes to develop the technology to quickly roll out the vaccine to put this pandemic behind us.
You can see which one of us can eat the most cookies later this morning on Facebook Live. That will be what, around a little after seven-ish?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little after seven-ish. So we've
got to be. Brianna's already prepping. Sure, yeah. Has a full plate.
This is my breakfast.
Pauline thinks she's gonna win, but
I'm gonna win. You know.
I mean, this is. You guys can dream, but.
I like it.
You're listening to Ed Sheeran's Shape of You, and that's because
we're still dancing.
This was the most streamed song of the decade.
All right, 6:46. Hey, we've got a special guest for the dog walking forecast.
Say hi, Buddy. This is Buddy. I'm sure a lot of people may know him, but he's my sweet pup. Adopted him from the McCracken County Humane Society. He's a great dog.
And you're being such a good boy, Buddy.
Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day?
Every year, as the years go on, we reflect back on the tragedies, the pain, and the loss from September 11th, 2001. But we also remember the strength, resiliency, and how our nation was able to come together to help those who needed it the most. No matter how old you were, no matter where you were, you remember 9/11. It's not something that you forget.
Mm-mm.
So we wanted to share what our experience was with all three of us. Winter is here, and that means a number of places will start experiencing new challenges brought on by cold weather and compounded by the coronavirus pandemic. That includes the homeless population. Your generosity will help 9 local agencies, including St. Vincent de Paul. And this morning we are joined by the lovely Norma Cox, the infamous Norma Cox that many of you know and love.
Good morning, Paducah.
Exactly.